Okay, I got my chimney on here, and I used some chocolate candy rocks to sort of make it look like a stone chimney. As you decorate your house, there are some things that you need to do right away, like stick, if you're going to do spice drops on the roof, you're going to want to put your spice drops on while this frosting is soft, because once it gets hard, you'll be hard-pressed to push these down into the icing. You want to make a nice arrangement of colors. Also, if you're doing this with children, remember to have extra stuff, because probably every other one is going to go in your mouth. Mm-hmm. I'm going to switch to a smaller tube here. This is going to be a number 18 star tube, just to give it a little different texture. And I'll do just a basic, and then meat. This is the hard part of working around your chimney, but if you don't put your chimney on early and let it set, you'll be sorry. And now you can see also it doesn't matter quite so much how perfect your gingerbread pieces were, because you're going to cover up pretty much all of it with frosting. This is royal icing that I'm using, and remember to keep it covered when you're not actually using it, because if you're slow, the icing will get hard and crusty, and then you won't be able to squeeze it through the tube.
How's that best stored?
This is best stored in the refrigerator, covered. Another thing I have found with the pre-made kits for gingerbread houses, you never get enough icing. So I like to make my own, and the recipe will be posted. I use meringue powder. 8 ounces of water, 2.5 ounces of meringue powder, 2.5 pounds of powdered sugar, and 1/2 ounce of cream of tartar. And probably the most expensive ingredient these days will be the cream of tartar. You can also do this with egg white and not use the meringue powder, but some people are a little hesitant to allow kids to work with anything that still has raw egg in it, that has not been processed through a cooking process. We can do a little bit more back here and add some of our Christmas lights. It's just like Christmas. You can do these way ahead of time. You can make really small ones and turn them into Christmas ornaments. You can make large ones just to get the whole family in the mood for Christmas. You can decorate your windows. And the store, the candy store, is absolutely the best place to go to get all of your goodies for decorating. I like little snowmen. There's many, many other candy canes. One thing that's important, if you're using the candy cane type candy, that is it's a melted sugar candy, any kind, whether it's the little round things with the red stripes in it or if it's candy canes, once you unwrap those and put them on the gingerbread house, they will start to dissolve. So it's better to use the molded sugar decorations or leave your candy canes wrapped, because they will, depending on the humidity in your house, over 2 or 3 weeks, begin to dissolve and run down. Oh, this side's pretty good. This side we're going to use little Christmas ornaments. This is the part where we can go to town on the front yard. This is why I like to keep the front of the board fairly open so that I can put lots of goodies. Depending on what you have on hand, you can use cookie cutters and cut out cookie shapes for trees in the front yard. That's always good. Or snowman cutters to cut out little snowmen. Or you can use your royal icing and make your own snowmen. If you're going to add anything like the white nonpareils or the snowflake quins, this would be the time to do it. You don't want to wait for this to dry and set, because if it does, none of your goodies will stick to it. These are just white nonpareil seeds, and I'm going to give a generous little sprinkle of these guys, maybe some up top. You can see I should have done this sooner, because they just bounce off if the icing is not still wet. So do as I say, not as I do.
That fresh snow look.
Yeah, it's hard to pick up on the camera. Camera doesn't see the white on white so well, but it makes a really stunning display in the house. Don't forget your door. My first thought was always, okay, well, the door's opening like this, but I don't want to show this back side of my cookie, so I'll flip it around and have my door open like that. Again, you can add another gingerbread person up front, some tree cookies, maybe some snowflake decons. A wreath. Don't be afraid to color your royal icing either. You can do that, and if I could find some cinnamon imperials. Yeah. Well, for the lack of being able to find my cinnamon imperials, I'm going to use a holly molded sugar decoration. And we've got the rest of the family here. Don't forget the kids.
That's great.